अस्सलाम वालेकुम, दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर सीरा सीरीज एंड दिस इज़ अबाउट कुसैब इनकलाब. नाउ इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी वर डिस्कसिंग द लीडरशिप ऑफ मक्का विच वॉज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सिटी. इट वॉज द सेंटर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. इट वॉज वेयर द हाउस ऑफ अल्लाह वॉज एंड इट वॉज वेयर ऑल द पिलग्रिम्स यूज टू कम टू पे होमेज. नाउ द लीडरशिप ऑफ मक्का हैज स्टेड विद बनी जरहूम. बनी जरहूम वर द ट्राइब हु हैड सेटल्ड डाउन first in the city after Ismail alayhi salam and Hazrat Hajra, and Bani Jurhum were the in-laws of Ismail alayhi salam. Bani Jurhum lived in the city for 21 centuries and had leadership of it for 20 of them. Then after their corruption and exploitation of pilgrims, they were evicted by Bani Khuza with the support of the Ismailites. Bani Khuza ruled the city for 3 centuries. They had absolute control related to pilgrimage, most especially, and all other things. Now a time came when a chief of Khuza called Hulail married his daughter to a Quraysh gentleman, and Quraysh were obviously descendants of the Ismailite Arabs. He married his daughter to a Quraysh gentleman. His name was Kusay bin Kilab. Now here you have to imagine a very charismatic personality, because you are talking about a tribe that has been controlling a city for 3 centuries, and in this day and age it's hard to imagine any one family leading a country for 3 centuries. The last instance that we can remember in history, maybe one of them, is the Ottomans, and yet even that's so long ago, and now we cannot imagine a family leading a country for 3 centuries. In fact, even 3 decades is a long time. And if a man comes and challenges the authority of that same family, and he is so impressive that people generally agree that he is the one who should get leadership, he has to be extremely charismatic, possibly good looking, extremely efficient, well off, and highly trusted. So Kusay bin Kilab was that kind of a gentleman. And so as he became the leader of Makkah, finally after years, Quraysh were now the tribe that was leading Makkah, and Quraysh were descendants of the Ismailite Arabs. This was the first time that the descendants of Ismailite Arabs were controlling the city of Makkah. Kusay set up a house of parliament that was called Darun Nadwa, where the Quraysh used to meet and discuss all their issues and resolve all their problems. Now since he was a leader, he had privileges which could also be counted as duties. He had founded the Darun Nadwa, and ever since his time, these were the privileges and duties of leadership of Makkah that were counted for people who came after him as well. And so they are very important. We need to focus on them. One thing is authority over the Darun Nadwa, presiding over the Darun Nadwa. Then their banner of war. Obviously, everybody has their specific banner of war, and the leader of Makkah would have control of that. Then one privilege was holding the keys to the Kaaba, another was providing water for pilgrims, and sometimes pilgrims used to come who could not afford their own food. So one duty was food for pilgrims, and Quraysh used to actually collect land tax from residents of the city in order to pay for that food. Now Kusay had sons, but the two sons we talk about most and know about most in history are Abduddar, the oldest, and Abdumunaf, one of the youngest. Abdumunaf in his turn had 4 sons that we know of: Al-Mutlib, Hashim, who was basically named Amr, and his twin Abdushams. And then there was Nawfal, who was half-brother to Hashim. Hashim in his turn had a son called Abdul-Mutlib. He had other sons as well, but Abdul-Mutlib is the one who is relevant in history. His son Abdullah, again he was one of many sons, was married to Amina, and they were the parents of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's generally agreed that Abdumunaf was the most outstanding of Kusay's sons, but because of his strong personality, there wasn't any leadership conflict amongst his sons. The leadership conflict happened in the generation of Hashim, and that we will cover in later videos. Thank you.